Hi guys, I am traveling in beautiful Thailand right now, but I have to take a break and make video for you guys because the new Corona Renderer 11 just came out. This video is sponsored by Chaos Group. We have a few very interesting features and some improvements. Let me present to you everything that is new in this version. This feature is awesome. Now we can create very advanced styles using Corona Tile Map.
We can find it in the Corona Maps. To make use of this, we have to create the material first and plug the map, for example, into the base color slot. Let's add the UVW map modifier straight away to see the mapping properly. The parameters tab is where the magic happens. You can choose the tile pattern from the list. We can change the color of the tile. We can also adjust the size of the tiles, so its width and height. Changing the gap's color and thickness is also possible. With these options, we can customize the pattern however we want. We can also add the maps instead of the color for both tiles and gaps. Additionally, we can round the corners of the tiles and blur the gaps. We have also options for the tile mapping. I show you this in a second. But first, I want to show you that we can also make some randomization, which is pretty useful to create realistic outputs. We can, for example, randomize the width. For instance, a value of 50% means the tile will have random width in the interval 50%-150% of the tile width. Or we can randomize the shrinking U or V. For instance, a value of 10% means the tile width will be 90%-100%. The same for the row height or offsets. And we can also randomize rotation. Adding a bit of that will help in creating more realistic results.
This is awesome.
Going back to the patterns, I reset all the tile randomization so we can see properly what patterns do we have. We have all the most popular patterns you can think of. You don't have to struggle anymore if you cannot find the proper map pattern. You can create your own material with this map. The cool thing about this is that it not only has pre-made patterns, but also we can create a customized one. We just have to adjust the values here and we can create something very specific. And again, by adding some randomization, we can create really realistic results.
Great!
Now let's test how it works with maps. I add Corona multiple map to create randomization. To make it work, we have to choose the tiles ID option. Great, and now you can see that we can change the tile mapping. Per tile works the best in this case. We can set if the texture will be cropped or stretched. To keep the original proportions of the texture patterns, I choose the crop. One unique power of the Corona tile map is having multiple outputs. We can simply add extra outputs here instead of copying the map to the other slots. This way, we can keep in sync if we decide to change the pattern or its parameters. We can use Corona color to get a white and black tile map, but we can also use textures instead. Then we just have to plug the additional output into the correct slot of the material.
Let's see how it looks on render.
Here we go. You can see that we can create nice tiles with this map. We can add extra outputs and create other maps, for example, for the base roughness, reflections, and so on. A very powerful map.
Let's stay in the material editor. The next update is Corona Edge Map. With this map, we can easily apply effects like weathering and staining to the edges of the objects. The new edge map creates a color gradient based on how far a point is from a geometric edge. This is particularly useful for objects with no thickness, like leaves, for example.
Let me show you how it works, based on this plant. Let's unplug the base color map and look for the Corona edge map. Plug it into the base color slot so we can see how it works. We can change two parameters here. We can change the distance near and distance far. The smaller the distance far, the less of the black color we can see on the edges. We can also adjust the effect by editing the curve. Now, we can plug the original map into the far slot and create a darker version of the map for the near map. Let me show you the difference again. It really adds realism to the material, a cool option.
We have two updates for Chaos Scatter. Now we can define upper and lower limits for scattering.
As an example, I created a Chaos Scatter with pines in the mountain terrain. If you go to the Surface Scattering tab, you'll see the new option, Altitude Limitation. We have to turn it on. We can define the range of altitude units, either in the word or position independent mode. It's super useful when you have terrain with various altitudes. We can also adjust this by changing the falloff curve.
With the second update, you can have scatter objects look in the same direction.
It will work pretty well with people models, for example. In the Chaos Scatter, we have to turn on the Look At option. We just have to choose the target object, so the one at which the models will be looked at. Next, we have to select which of the model object's axis gets turned towards the direction. We can also use reverse to make sure we get the results we want. You can see now that when I move the target object, the scattered objects move towards its direction. Nice! Except for this, we can also use the horizontal option. Then the selected look at axis gets turned only within a plane that is perpendicular to the normal. To add some randomization, we can use falloff distance or falloff curve. I really like this option.
Next, the power tools. This nice little toolbar with a set of handy scripts.
If you watch this channel, you know I love custom toolbars and scripts. All of the features from the toolbar I already have in my custom toolbar.
So it's not a big deal for me, but I'm telling you, if you don't have them, it will save you a ton of time. Let me go through each feature.
First, object replacer. You can add an object and then replace other objects for this one. You can also choose the cloning type, which is super handy. Click Start Preview to see the changes, and whenever you're happy with the results, you can apply the changes. Super handy one. I use this option often when I forget to create a proxy object and I already copy it around the scene. I just select the object that is a proxy and I replace the other models later on. We have also a tool for changing the pivot of multiple objects. For instance, we can choose the center here for a single axis or all of them. We can also offset the pivot if we wish. This option can save lots of time.
Great!
Transform Randomizer is awesome. We can randomize translation, rotation, or scale by choosing the variation range. It's pretty useful if you want to create some randomization to the objects in the scene, like here for the chairs, so they don't look perfectly placed, or in the exterior scenes to randomize plants.
I really like it.
The selection randomizer is cool too. We can select by count or percentage. So depending on the value we type, it will select random objects for us. Here we go, 5 objects are selected. Can be very handy for creating randomization. And at the end, we have a scene cleaner. With just one click, we can clear various things. The red boxes are a warning that this operation cannot be undoable. Let me show you one example, cleaning empty layers. One click and all unnecessary layers are gone. Perfect.
On top of that, there are a few smaller improvements.
They have improved normal bump filtering. It reduces the loss of detail in those channels when using a smaller render resolution or moving an object further away from the camera.
There is a new denoiser option, Intel Denoiser.
It can run on a CPU or GPU.
Also, with Corona 11, now you can take advantage of the color management options offered by the latest version of 3ds Max. And that's it. Let me know in the comments what is your favorite feature and what would you like to see in the next version. Bye-bye!